A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Then the righteous will stand with great confidence in the presence of those who have oppressed them and those who make light of their labors. When the unrighteous see them, they will be shaken with dreadful fear, and they will be amazed at the unexpected salvation of the righteous. They will speak to one another in repentance, and in anguish of spirit they will groan, "These are persons whom we once held in derision and made a byword of reproach. Fools that we were. We thought that their lives were madness and that their end was without honor. Why have they been numbered among the children of God? And why is their lot among the holy ones? Because the hope of the ungodly is like thistledown carried by the wind, and like a light frost driven away by a storm. It is dispersed like smoke before the wind, and it passes like the remembrance of a guest who stays but a day. But the righteous live forever, and their reward is with the Lord. The Most High takes care of them. Therefore, they will receive a glorious crown and a beautiful diadem from the hand of the Lord, because with his right hand he will cover them, and with his arm he will shield them." The word of the Lord.
My spirit. A reading from the Revelation to John. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away. I saw no temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God, the Almighty, and the Lamb. And the city has no need of sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God is its light, and its lamp is the Lamb. The nations will walk by its light, and the kings of the earth will bring their glory into it. Its gates will never be shut by day, and there will be no night there. People will bring into it the glory and the honor of the nations. But nothing unclean will enter it, nor anyone who practices abomination or falsehood, but only those who are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Then the angel showed me the river of the water of life, bright as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb through the middle of the street of the city. On either side of the river is the tree of life with its 12 kinds of fruit, producing its fruit each month, and the leaves of the tree are for the healing of the nations. Nothing accursed will be found there anymore, but the throne of God and of the Lamb will be in it, and his servants will worship him. They will see his face, and his name will be on their foreheads. And there will be no more night. They need no light of lamp or sun, for the Lord God will be their light, and they will reign forever and ever." The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Good evening, friends. For those of you who are here and for those who are streaming with us tonight, we are so pleased that you've joined us for this holy evening. This is a time every year when we gather to celebrate All Saints Day and All Souls Day, traditionally, and in calendars around the world, November 1st and November 2nd. And we bring them together in a fulsome New Testament understanding, as you will see quoted in Ned's notes from the first letter to the Philippians, or the letter to the Philippians, the first sentence, in Paul's greeting to all the saints, we are gathered. And so here we are gathered to remember in particular those who we have loved and lost. And tonight we remember in particular also Dean Robert Andrew Willis, who, as many of you know, was here preaching and sharing his great gift of holiness with us, and his final sermon and his final podcast here from the altar at 4 o'clock 3 weeks ago. And Dean Robert died the following Tuesday. And I note in particular how wonderful it is that we are celebrating his life, in part as we celebrate the lives of all those we love in this evensong, because as so many of you know, when the Anglican Church came into being, it set that the scriptures were to be heard and to be sung daily in all of the cathedrals in England and in the Anglican churches beyond. And so Dean Robert spent 30 years as deans of cathedrals, and his last 21 as the Dean of Canterbury Cathedral, and so therefore was soaked in the scriptures, going through them fully every 3 years, and the sound tonight would be and is an absolute sweetness to the soul. As the Kaddish, which is about to be sung by Lydia, I invite all of you to bring a memento to the altar so that they might be blessed as we bless those in the hearts of the ones that we love. As you know, the stirring music of the soul that we hear tonight, the holy sweetness that is a great deep spiritual consolation to it, comes because so many in our community offer so much of themselves to be able to produce such beautiful music. And I hope that again you'll read Ned's notes, because they speak of Maurice Durafley, and Ned is a great keeper, our maestro Ned Tipton is a great keeper of the Durafley way, friends with Madame Durafley and the keeper of the Durafley piano and the keeper in his heart of all things in that whole world that the Durafleys interpreted. I want to say again, and as you might hear if I speak on Sunday mornings and you're a part of that congregation, how blessed we are to have Ned as our maestro. And I want to have you note that the beautiful music, so much of it tonight is set by Ned. He has snuck that in with his little EJT in the orders of service, but the praises and the responses and the canticles, the mag and the nunc as they are known, are set by Ned. And I want to give, on behalf of all of us, I know the people in the choir can hear me, a grateful thanks to them for their work that they put in so that this sound of the soul might touch us all deeply. And as I noted this morning, we are so blessed to welcome Ned's friend and colleague and Christopher Houlihan, who in his latter 20s came to work with Ned when Ned was the maestro at the American Cathedral in Paris. And now, of course, Christopher, brilliant as he is, has a post to Trinity College and travels the world sharing his gift. I also would invite all of you, if you're not yet a member and a part of the Friends of Music, which is the ministry that does such incredible things to support our life in the musical world here. And an offering to support the Friends is an offering to support the holiness of beauty and the beauty of holiness. And I invite all of you to please come to a reception that follows, for we delight. Jesus ate with his friends, and we hope you will come and eat with all of us so that we may be friends in particular. And I'm very thankful to Beth Ralston and Ellen McMahon and Cindy Ty and Amy Reed for putting that for the reception on, and for Ted, seated in the back corner, who will be our bartender. You'll notice on the back there that quite shockingly to those who are professionals in the church, the next performance is Lessons and Carols. It's Christmas time, and I won't miss that because I know once again your souls will be stirred. In a minute, there will be an offertory, and for that, I hope that we will all walk in love as Christ has loved us and given himself an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you. Let us pray for those whom we love but see no longer. We give them back to thee, dear Lord, who gavest them to us. Yet as thou dost not lose them in giving, so we have not lost them by their return. Not as the world giveth, givest thou, O lover of souls. What thou gavest, thou takest not away. For what is thine is ours also, if we are thine. And life is eternal, and love is immortal, and death is only an arising. And an arising is nothing save the limit of our sight. Lift us up, strong Son of God, that we may see further. Cleanse our eyes, that we may see more clearly. Draw us closer to thyself, so that we may know ourselves to be nearer to our loved ones who are with thee. And while thou dost prepare a place for us, prepare us also for that happy place, that where thou art, we may be also forevermore. Amen.
Thank you.
Please kneel as you are able. Together we pray. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, thine unworthy servants, do give thee glory. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for thine inestimable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Amen.